welcome. Today, I wanted to share with you a fun and slightly unusual watercolour technique. It's unusual for me because I normally just go straight in and paint in my splashy, loose, expressive style, which is pretty much what you can see me doing here. And I'm painting hydrangeas today, but one of the things I love about them is that they are composite blooms, and normally in my style I don't get to kind of focus on that much. So today I want to do that. I'm not going to paint anything like a realistic botanical by any stretch of the imagination, but I do want to focus on those individual blooms, and I want a bit of help from a kitchen supply. Yes, that's it, you can see me putting down right now. It's cling film, and I'm going to use this to give me a bit of a head start for some negative painting when it dries, and I'll show you a bit more about that in a minute. To do this cling film technique, you need to have quite a lot of juicy paint on your painting, and that's what you saw me put down first, and then you scrumple up the cling film and press it into the paint. You'll see what happens, and you can kind of manipulate the patterns to some extent. But part of the joy of it, for me anyway, is that you don't know what you're going to get. It's a kind of random effect that you can work on. You then have to be very patient and let the whole thing dry, especially overnight. That's kind of ideal, because if you lift the plastic off before it's properly dry, you won't get those effects at all. Now let me zoom in so you can see what I'm talking about. Where that cling film has made contact with the paint on the paper, it's made a kind of darker mark. So you end up with these sort of haphazard, random, organic shapes that are a lot of fun to work with, because if you are trying to bring out the little individual composite blooms in the hydrangea blossom, those are kind of a starting point. And sometimes you have to be a bit patient and spend a bit of time staring at what you've got. It's a bit like finding shapes in the clouds, you know, that game we used to play as kids, where you're staring at these fuzzy shapes and strange lines until you start, your mind starts putting together the hydrangea, and you start to see where those individual little petals should be. And then once you've done that, it kind of gives you a few ideas of where you might like to create some of these little composite flowers by painting effectively around the flowers, which is what I was referring to before as negative painting. So that's where you're not painting the thing, which would be the tiny little petal, you're painting the shape around that petal. And what I'm going to do is keep using the negative painting technique and a little bit of positive painting, which is painting the petal itself, as opposed to negative painting, which is painting around the petal. But you can use both of those techniques to kind of build on this base layer that the cling film has created. So what I like to do is I'm using pretty much the same colours that were already in that first layer with the cling film. So that's, I think what I'm working on now is probably alizarin crimson or something like that. So I'm using that to bring out the edge of a petal here and there. And I prefer to not do the whole little mini flower. What I mean is you don't want to go all the way around the outside like you're outlining a cartoon version of the petal. It's often better if you just pull out one little edge. I think part of the reason this kind of painting is so appealing is that it gives the viewer something to do, because when you're looking at the painting, your brain automatically starts filling in the missing pieces. So it makes it a little bit more of an interactive thing. Instead of staring at a perfectly articulated, realistic image, the painting kind of draws you in and lets your imagination fill in any gaps. So when I look at hydrangeas, and when I'm doing this, I do have a whole lot of pictures open in front of me on my iPad. So I'm looking at not one single picture of hydrangeas, but many, many of them, to give me some ideas. And sometimes you spend a bit of time staring at those pictures and then you look at your painting and you can see something very similar, which you can try and replicate. And you're really just looking for dark edges and dark shapes. It helps if you're not thinking quite so much of petals, but just of these unusual organic shapes that you're getting. And I've decided, as you can see, to pop in some background. I suppose I'm going for a semi-abstract feel here, where I've just got this one big cluster of hydrangeas, or perhaps two sort of heads of those hydrangea flowers together on the bush. So I'm using the colours I've already used in those flowers, as well as some greens, to paint a bit of background. Because on those outside edges, it's really when I paint the background that you start to see where the edge of this bloom is. And in some cases, it's rather nice, I think, if you don't have an edge. We call those lost edges, where because of the light, perhaps the edge of the bloom sort of disappears into the background, into the shadows. So you can see there, for example, in the top right-hand corner, I've popped in, that's one of my favourite colours, it's quinacridone violet, and just let that drift out into the background so that the background and the flowers kind of blend together. And I'm going backwards and forwards between the background and the flowers, because that also, it's something you get used to because the paper is drying as you go around. So there might be an area that you feel is too wet to drop a mark in. If you go and work somewhere else on the paper, you can come back and back to that stage later when it's an appropriate dryness for what you wanted to do. And there I'm working on those little edges of the individual blooms, as well as putting in the odd centre. Because when I look at photos of hydrangeas, the things that strike me are those little centres that you see here and there, the centre of each individual mini flower on the composite bloom, as well as the edges and the shadows of those, the multiple blooms create against one another, because they kind of, they overlap. So I'm using my favourite purples to pull out some of those shadows and show the edges of some of the other small petals. One of the hardest things is to work out when to stop, of course, because this is the sort of thing where you could just keep going and keep going. And if you do that, eventually you'll end up with a fairly realistic drawing. And my aim is always to stop well before that happens, to keep it sort of loose and lively, expressive feel. And at this point, I'm really just enjoying all those marvellous colours together that blend so well. I do like to make sure that I have some of the green in the middle of those big clusters of flowers, because, as we said, those little mini blooms overlap and cross over one another, but there are also places where there are gaps, and through those gaps we can see the stems and the leaves, so those are obviously parts that should, I think, be green. And it kind of ties the whole painting together, because that green, that's another one of my favourite colours, it's perylene green, and it's very useful because it's also quite a good shadow colour, that's quite a blue-green. Well, this painting is pretty much done now, but I'd love to know, have you ever used cling film in your painting? Let me know in the comments, and don't forget to give this video a like if you enjoyed it, and subscribe to see more. Thank you for watching. See you next time. Happy painting.